We've finally reached the end of this incredible year for music. After a few months of reevaluating, re-listening, reshuffling everything, and organizing all the stuff that's come out this year, I've managed to put together my top 10 songs of 2023. I only have a few parameters for this, of course. Number one, I want to stress this is only my opinion on the best songs. There's nothing objective about this, and this might not even necessarily be on technicality, on the song as a whole, but really just what I needed in my spirit and myself for the year, whatever clicked with me, whatever felt like it was the song that I needed to carry me through the year. At least for this list, I'm going to be keeping it strictly to the progressive scene with progressive rock, progressive metal, and my only other rule is that I'm doing a maximum of 2 songs per band, because there are a few instances where I could see more than 2 slipping into the list for a few bands, and I wanted to spread it out, diversify it as much as I could so I could show my love to as many bands as I can. For those kind of bands where I could have included more, I will put some of those songs into my honorable mentions, but I really don't want to waste any more time. My top 10 songs of 2023 are starting now with number 10. In at my number 10, I have Falling Away by Temek, the second single off of their debut album, Terror Management Theory. This song just epitomizes and embodies what that entire album means, the entire sonic value of that album. All of the riffs, all of the heartwarming melodies, the fast-paced rhythms, the odd time signatures come together in perfect harmony on that song. I loved many other songs on that album. All 3 of the singles they put out were nearly equally brilliant, and it was really hard for me to pick which song to throw into this spot, but I went with this one just because it is so tight, the structure of it all, and it keeps building on itself. Besides the chorus, there is no part of the song that repeats. It always is evolving its sound, and the state of it becomes more complex. This is everything I would want from a prog supergroup, as you would call them. I also want to give a humongous shout out to Seaman, or Simon, however you say his name. I apologize if I got it wrong there. But his drum parts on this album are absolutely exceptional, and this song might even be my favorite drum song of the year. Some of the grooves he pulled out were really blowing my mind during the reaction, and as I keep listening, you keep hearing more intricacies in it. The fluid transitions between time signatures and those 16th note hi-hat grooves, particularly the one he moves on to the china in the outro of the song, are just so tasteful, complement Frederick's beautiful voice perfectly, and all in all, I am an absolute sucker for songs in 7/4. This song simply has no faults. Now let's go into something a little bit slower for my number 9. Cure by Aviations is in at my number 9, and it just holds this vulnerable, raw feeling that isn't usually found in music nowadays. I've been tracking these guys for a while now, checking out the singles on this album, but this is the first one that really truly caught my eye and my ear and told me that these guys were going to be a force in the future. Seeing that they worked with Michael Lesser, the genius frontman of the Contortionists, to get this song done, work on the music video and the production, gave me extremely high hopes for it, and they were exceeded listening to the song. All of the instrumentation and the vocals just feel effortless in here, and having Michael on board to help such talented Berklee-level musicians hone in on this one idea and let it shine through the music was exactly what I felt like they needed to do. They pulled it off flawlessly. It is one of the most heart-wrenching, deep, soaking choruses of the year, especially those lines telling you to breathe through the pain. There were a lot of intense emotional songs that I really couldn't handle listening to this year during such a crazy year of high school, but this is a song that actually helped me through those moments. And the outro after that final chorus, pushing itself into those arpeggiated guitar melodies, remind me a lot of Flying by Carmen Jacca, which is a brilliant thing, has such a soaring climax to the song, and just the little nuances, the details, bring this song from an A up to an A+. The way they crescendo slightly more tweak some little things in each chorus to slowly bring up the power, the emotional impact. The production is excellent on this as well. I love this song, and I'm so glad I got more into Aviations this year. My number 8 is an entry from, for me, easily, by far and away, the most underrated band to come out of this year. It's Isbjorg, who still have under 1,000 monthly listeners on Spotify and deserve to be up beyond the millions with their incredible, pure, progressive sound. They put out 4 singles for an upcoming album next year. Definitely go check all of them out if you haven't. They're all fantastic, and it will make you much, much more excited and more aware for their album coming out next year. But this song touched me even more than the first 3 just because of that added feature in there. Female vocals are absolutely perfect. The little call and responses and the harmonies that they bring into the climax of the song to bring it forward are unlike anything I've heard this year, and for me, by far, the best collaboration effort of the year. The climaxes and the vocals show the higher register that the band has to offer vocally, something that you haven't really heard before from them or heard them pull off to this caliber. The motivation levels flying out of the song are so high. They're a band that I love because they're bringing this uplifting happiness to the progressive scene that you don't see a lot, and it really feels like what I needed this year and what I want to see more of. Somehow bringing in the emotional hopefulness without it feeling too cheesy, corny, or underbaked. This is done just perfectly. All the transitions, perfect progressive listening for any music fan out there. This might be the most beautiful song of the year. My number 7 was an inevitable pick for me ever since it came out. It is the Danish progressive metal gods Vola, who returned 2 years after their album The Witness to put out Paper Wolf, the only single they released this year, coming out around the end of summer. And all it has done is left me waiting for more singles and the announcement of an album for 2024. My favorite thing about the song is that it feels like a perfect mesh and blend of all 5 of Vola's releases so far, taking all the highlights from those, some of the synth work, syncopation from the Monsters era, the drumming, the riffs, the guitar melodies coming in from In Mazes, the beautiful ethereal, almost lullaby-like hooks from Applause of a Distant Crowd, the genty, riffy breakdowns from The Witness, and then beauty encompassed in their first EP as well. This song is tight, it's punchy, it's electric, it's powerful, and that chorus, after you hear it enough times, always stays in your head. Chorus that motivates me too, thinking about the future of this band. The wolf really is coming with these guys. Vola are gonna take over next year. I think this next album could be their best yet and one of the best albums of all time, but this song doesn't fall short of anything. They have never released a bad song, and this goes right up near the top of this year for me. Riff work, synth work, drumming, vocals, the melodies, the intense chunky bass tone are all there in such a classic Vola fashion, and that breakdown snuck up on me and knocked my face off. So no surprises there. It's Vola, Paper Wolf in at number 7 for me. And now with number 6, a band that has really pleasantly surprised me this year with their singles. My number 6 is a song that shocked me with its excellence upon the first listen, because Caligula's Horse were a band that I wasn't quite able to get into over the last year, and this song solidified me being a fan for the future. This also acted as a gateway for me back into their past discography to realize that I had been missing out completely the entire time. Upon the time of hearing this, Gollum was the best I had ever heard from the band. Within such a short, tight, punchy song, there were so many riffs and transitions. The riff work on the song is absolutely electric. The power chords, the syncopation on that intro, and then going into an almost slow violence-like verse. The chorus is huge, atmospheric, and so perfectly Caligula's horse when you listen to it. Some of the transition riffs that come in at unexpected times, just that little punch they give, the variations, the way they transition into the halftime, the way they change up the groove a little bit with the bass drum, just the bass tones coming in stronger at points, and some excellent syncopated, complicated vocal parts that go over these lines so well. It is such a well-written song for me melodically. The guitar solo in it doesn't feel overdone, which is one of my main gripes with the band in the past, but they've all started to grow on me more, realizing just how good of a musician he is and the whole band are, but nothing is overdone here. It has such a sweet feeling, and that little bridge section in the middle, transitioning in and out of those riffs, going up that little scale, they have a Vola feel to them with that almost lullaby state going into that bendy djent riff that comes out of it. This is something that I've always wanted to hear from the band. That is one of the best compliments I can give, just with how good Vola are, and it suits their style so well. So I was so happy to see Caligula's Horse taking this approach, and I think Charcoal Grace could end up being the best album next year. The absolute raw beauty of the first 2 minutes within this song have been blowing me away ever since I first heard it. My number five is La Jolla off of Aviation's new album Luminaria. I've been surprised to see so many people seeming to underrate the slower, more focused songs on this album, because to me, this is Aviation's at their absolute best. As I was saying earlier when talking about Pure, just seeing these musicians who are so incredibly talented and gifted, honing in on one specific idea, slowing it down, and just oozing their talent into the seams of these ballads, produces some of the most incredible jaw-dropping music that you can hear. And La Jolla encompasses it all, the melodies, the harmonies, all of the complication in it. It's one of the densest, richest ballads you'll hear. It doesn't feel overdone at all in any part of the song. These guys absolutely stole a special place in my heart with the song, and I truly cannot stop listening to it. My first reaction to the song just filled me with something that I'd never felt before, and that's what I want music to do. La Jolla is a beautiful, beautiful song, the best off of Luminaria for me, and absolutely solidified me as an Aviation's fan moving forward. It's a beautiful, beautiful effort. And at my number four, we have the song that completely messed up my pre-made Songs of the Year list when it came out later at the end of the year. This is The World Breathes With Me by Caligula's Horse, and we now see that both of the singles they've released this year have slotted comfortably into my top 10. These are the two best songs that I've heard from them, my two favorites, and it has me so incredibly excited for the album coming out next year and for their upcoming US tour. This song is brilliant. Brilliant, epic. If you thought there were a lot of riffs in Gollum, go listen to this song. They bring even more power, even more punch in just the best places possible, coming in and out of these verses, the choruses, into the different climaxes, and that outro riff coming out, screaming, "The World Breathes With Me," uniting everything, every element, every detail from the song into one powerful moment, exhaling into that riff to end the song. One of my moments of the year, and the best riff I've heard this year as well. The band said the song encompasses everything that you'll be hearing across Charcoal Grace, as it is the first song on the album. And if that's the case, I expect nothing but absolutely special quality songs on that album. They bring in more of the dreamy, eerie, almost hopeful, melancholic moments into this song, break it up, and lots of good uses of giving us breathing space, slower moments to make the impacts even stronger, and the guitar solo absolutely mesmerizing on the song. This is the best epic I've heard from them, and I think the best song I've heard from them as well. Caligula's Horse are on an absolute mission to take over 2024. They started it off in the right way at the end of this year. This song is a beautiful moment in progressive history. Anyone who's been watching my channel for a little bit now probably could have been expecting this pick, not only because of how much I've been praising Carmen Jacca this year, but also the fact that this song comes in the intro to my channel, which serves purpose because I've had at least 30 or 40 people asking me what that riff is from, and as they should, because the intro of the song is just absolutely stunning. This is Carmen Jacca's Breathing in at my number 3, and it's the first song from their Ancient Skills EP that they released earlier in the year. The way they weave the whole song around these beautiful, drawn-out, delicate, harp-like notes in the background give it such a meditative, beautiful, reflective feeling. And just marinating yourself in all of the different bends, the guitar tones, the lush vocals, and the humongous atmosphere that it creates is one of my favorite experiences of the year upon the first listen. This was more or less my introduction to pure raw fall riffs, and hearing it with such delicate, beautiful vocals made it just that bit more special. These guys are onto something absolutely groundbreaking for me in the genre, and I think they've created some absolutely special moments in time on Ancient Skills. This song has blown me away in every way possible, and I keep unloading little bits of it as I listen to it. I think this is a perfect song. Uplifting, hopeful, progressive fall music is the future, and I really truly don't think you can get better than that. Nearing the end of the year, Earthside came out of absolutely nowhere and released an album that held the only song besides my number one for this year that challenged for that top spot. My number two for the year is Lesser Evil, and this is an absolute progressive epic at its finest. Far and away the most creative, most boundary-pushing, the most innovative song of the year for me. The blending of genres is absolutely insane and like nothing I've ever heard before. My first reaction to this, I was completely blown away and shocked listening to all of the mixing. It was one of the boldest things I've ever heard, and the fact that they were able to come together in such a unique way with such a long song and pull it off so flawlessly was just insane. The mixes of funk music, the mixes of jazz, of soul going into this with this progressive rock, progressive metal blend that keeps it churning, moving forward. The horns, the strings, the wails from the guest vocalist Larry are absolutely mind-blowing. This song is a magnum opus that you absolutely need to hear. This is a song that will change music, building around a feature in the best way possible. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful work. Earthside absolutely deserve a round of applause for this one. And before we get into my number one song of the year, I just wanted to shine a few light on some of the honorable mentions and, more importantly, some of the omissions from my list, because there really were so many songs competing to get on here this year. Any songs, even in my top 50, my top 100, are all brilliant, all on rotation, and this was a special year for music in my book, in alphabetical order. These are my honorable mentions. We'll be right back. And we've now reached my number one song for the year. I think people who might have seen some of my older videos from the beginning of the year would have expected this pick. There was a brief moment in time after The Lesser Evil came out that I was thinking maybe it could be fighting for the top spot. But besides that, this song has been far and away my song of the year since the moment I heard it. Nothing has competed with this. It's a perfect piece of art, and I truly believe it is a stepping stone and a ground mark in musical history. This song means so much to me. I believe it is a 100% perfect, uplifting, hopeful piece of progressive metal. This band has already been featured before in my list. This band is on my jacket. This is my favorite band that I've discovered this year, and such an incredible group of guys. It's no surprise to me that they're able to put out songs that are so special, so down to earth, and so groundbreaking within the genre. This song has absolutely carried me through the year. One of the greatest songs to ever, ever, ever be written. You may have seen it coming, you may have not, but either way, this is my number one song of 2023. So that's going to be it for my top 10 songs of 2023. Coming up next will be my top 5 albums of the year. Let me know what your top 10 songs are. Let me know your favorites from the year as well. Give me your top albums. I want to hear what you guys think about this year of music, if you have anything similar to me, if there's anything that you felt that I missed out that I should be aware of. I think 2023 was an excellent year for music, and the way it's shaping up, I think 2024 might be even better. So let's keep our heart open. Until next time.